Hey guys,
and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 5 of Project Infinity. Today I'm joined with my buddies A, Enterprise, and Chu Deller, and we're going to have to do a lot of amazing stuff today. Don't you guys think?
Durr!
Woo! But as you can see,
we do awesome stuff, so.
Yeah. So, as you guys can already see, we did ourselves a lot of work between the episodes, and I'm not even over exaggerating, like, an insane amount of stuff. So, yeah, let's get started quickly running you guys by what we did between the episodes, starting right here, I guess. So, as you can see, first of all, on my hotbar, I got myself a couple of goodies. I believe I made myself the goggles of revealing between the episodes, so that's one cool thing. I got myself the wand focus of equal trait. Again, I can't quite remember what I did last episode in between the episodes, so I'm just gonna run you by what I did, you know, rather lately. I got myself the Sigil of the Blood Lamp from A Enterprise, so thank you very much. Wow. I got Udeldor hitting me, but that's no surprise. I got myself a Dolly, pretty cool. Sleeping bag, cool stuff. Then what else do I got on me? I got myself the Rod of the Lands and a Flu Effect, so that's awesome stuff. And yeah, that's pretty much all the things that I actually made on me. One thing. I also turned my mana tablet into a band of mana, so I can wear it as a bubble. So that's pretty awesome. Yeah, that's, again, like I said, the stuff that I have on me. So then, outside. First of all, I pretty much replaced the watermill that we had right here. Pretty much we had two next to each other. I moved one of them over here, next to the newly made experience farm, made by Swans. Which is not that difficult, pretty much some autonomous activators and some essence berry bushes and some other fancy contraptions right here, pretty much turning making experience automatically. In combination with that, we got ourselves the Rosa Arcana, which is a flower from Botania, which makes mana from experience. So just standing near here will make ourselves a lot of experience. And of course, we can, you know, take more from this, so mana is no longer really a big issue. Awesome.
And that makes a lot of other things easier.
Yeah, that too. Like, an awful lot of things, so that's pretty awesome. I also made it just look a little bit nicer with Living Rock and Mana Glass, so yeah, that's pretty cool. Then I did myself a bunch of research between the episode, like crazy amounts of research. Pretty much all the stuff on the basic page, and I also found myself a Crimson Cult, so I got myself the book for that. Loads of wands and wand caps. Not that much stuff into alchemy, but I don't believe there is too much in this thingy anyway. Loads of artifacts, including infusion, which is one of the things I am planning on doing, or hopefully doing today, so stay tuned for that most definitely if you like that. Golemancy, got myself all the golems unlocked, at least almost all the golems. But yes, just a couple of more things to do. I know it was you. Then I got myself, let's see what else do we got, some Tomic Tinkerer stuff, like the Osmotic Enchanter, all that stuff I have researched, but that's pretty much it. And, Talisman of Withhold, no idea what this thing is, but it looks pretty cool. Let's see, what else, Apocrypha, nothing, B stuff, nothing, Applied Energistics, nothing, Tomic Esoterica, I probably really pronounce it way too bad, but I have no idea. Just a couple of things here, but I definitely want to see what else I can make with this mod, but most stuff requires infusion, so that's why I haven't done too much work into this yet. And, this is always empty. So, yes, that's pretty much the things that I researched. Then inside, as you can see, the base looks a lot cleaner now. Pretty much a bunch of bricks everywhere and wood in combination with just everything looking a lot cleaner in general, so that definitely helps to make us more productive, like always. Then I decided to completely overhaul the sorting system that we had. And by sorting system, I mean chests. there were way too many chests, so.
There was just a bunch of chests, and everyone was dumping everything everywhere that where it needed to go, because there were so many chests.
It was really bad before.
Exactly. So that's why, instead of having over 100 chests with like 3 different only three items in it. For example, like I believe we even had like a Miscraft chest that only had three items in it. Project Red with that two items or something. So wow. I decided to completely remake this entire room. Make myself a couple more barrels for the looks. A bunch of oak drawers, which we surprisingly already had, so just put them in here. And a bunch of diamond chests, pretty much making sorting a lot easier. Just sorting by Minecraft, mob drops, wooden materials, greenery, magic, tech, all the ores.
Might need to clean out the greenery chest soon, because it's getting full.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. Just tons of random stuff that we really don't need, so that's definitely something we should do rather soon. Then right here, down here, made it just look a lot cleaner. Again, just, you know, one difficult trait makes this thing look, or makes this stuff a lot easier. So yeah, it looks a lot cleaner. And then right here, I got myself a temporary roommate, which I want to put the Tonecraft infusion stuff in. That if I have the time, I will be making today, hopefully. So that is going to be pretty awesome, as there is a lot of stuff that can be infused that, well, pretty much, you know, I want to do at least someday, so why not make a start right now, I guess. And then up here, which is I think the biggest change in the, you know, aesthetical environment, which is something I designed, which is the powerhouses. As you can see right here, there are a couple of these houses right here, pretty much made out of wood mostly, that contain both water mills and a windmill. The windmill is purely aesthetical because I just love the way it looks and they don't generate that much power compared to these water wheels. But these water wheels, each set generates 90 RF per tick. And I believe we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them set up. So that's 540 redstone flux per tick. Which is not too bad actually if you ask me for what we currently need. So yeah, pretty cool.
Depends if they keep using the lasers this much for chipsets that don't get used.
Yeah, precisely.
Yeah, what's that for?
I have.
We have like endless chipsets.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Swans made them.
He don't probably is like just thinking like when no one is using them, might as well just activate it for some reason. I don't know.
Yeah.
But yeah, I just love the
I
way this looks.
To keep a few on hand, but that many?
Yeah, I know, right? Like, it's crazy. So yeah, I just love the way this looks down here. We do still have to clean this mess up just a little bit, as we completely man-made this entire mountain, because this thing is also completely, completely hollow from the inside, as you can see. So we might be able to.
I did it up, so we got rid of the mobs.
That's true. So that's pretty cool. Yeah. So this is pretty much now our new main power generation method for our house. And, you know, it looks a bit more aesthetical, just loads of little water creeks flowing down and, you know, wooden structures and everything. So yeah, that's pretty cool. What else do we have? Eagle started working on a little train station down there, but there's nothing really yet to show you guys there. Udeldor started with bees, which is pretty awesome. Yeah, that's pretty much all the awesome stuff that we have done between the episodes so far.
Watch your head, Udeldor, you might get stuck in the block.
So yeah,
happened to me a few times.
Pretty cool, I think. So let me prepare some stuff to actually get going with the possible Tonecraft stuff that I want to do today, and I will be right back with you guys. Alrighty, guys. So I think I got myself quite a cool plan of what I want to do. That includes hitting Udeldor, like always. which is, like I mentioned before, infusion crafting. So for that, I need a couple of things, which is the infusion matrix, which is expensive but doable. A couple of these arcane pedestals, which are a bit expensive but again quite doable. Let's see, what else do I need? Some essential distillation stuff, which is, well, yeah, you know the drill, doable, I think. Actually, did we find any silverwood trees?
I don't know, I haven't been out that far that much yet.
Yeah, I haven't seen any.
That means it's time for a journey after this. But first, let me make the stuff that I know I can make. So, like I said, I need a couple of shards. That should be enough, I think. Just requires a bunch of ordo, but I refilled my wand completely, so that should be good. So let's see, one of those right there. That thingy goes right there. Those shards, and I derped something up apparently. What did I do? Minecraft? Why? What did you do? Arcane stone blocks. And 6 different types. Wait, what? Infusion crafting. Oh, okay. I see. Why is this not crafting? This should be the recipe.
Is it uncrafting all the time again?
And no, it just doesn't show any recipe.
Is it Dumbcraft recipe?
It is a Dumbcraft recipe. Let me look in... Yeah, I am, but it doesn't show that. So let's look in and not enough items. Matrix.
That sounds painful.
Yeah. This is painful.
What are you trying to make?
A runic matrix. Ooh.
Blood runes. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think I have those spare.
Awesome. Let's see if we have those actual runes too. Damn it.
Yeah, I have 5 spare from when I upgraded my altar.
Cool. Let's see. Magic. We have rune of air. Do we need that? We do. Rune of earth, fire, water. Earth, water, fire. Awesome. That saves me 4 runes. And I need a rune of mana, which I can make, I think. But we don't have any, do we?
I don't think so.
Mana. No, we don't. Rune of mana. Requires... No, that's not rune of mana. Rune of mana. 3 mana steel, mana diamond, mana pearl, mana quartz, and a balanced shard. That's... Yeah, I think that's doable. So let me quickly put this stuff away that I don't need for now, because I need to get some other stuff. And I hate it that it actually showed a different recipe than it currently is. That sucks. So I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 shards to get myself... Oh, hey, thank you. Awesome. That saves me one more
step. You're lucky that I had to spare, otherwise I would have had to make them.
Yeah, true. So, yeah, let me quickly wait for this to get boiling up. Just a second. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1 balanced shard. Then I need 3 mana steel and a bunch of mana products. So, I need more mana steel, actually, too. 1, 2, and... Do we have more iron now?
Yeah, downstairs, processing. Awesome. Processed by now, probably.
Sure, then well, I will get that in a minute.
And I'm mining more, because the rituals... I just moved my rituals, so...
Cool. Oh wait, never mind, I do have enough mana still. There was some of it in the magic chest and some in the ores chest, so... That's...
Yeah, that's something that's kind of different to place. It belongs in both.
Yeah, precisely, we have to keep that in mind. Oh, and I need to get... What did I get again? Silverwood or Living Rock. That's the one. These names are so confusing from time to time. Like, yeah, just annoying. So I needed Balanced Shard. 1, 2, 3 of these. A Mana Pearl, Mana Diamond, Mana Quartz. I threw it in the wrong one, and instead of getting Mana Quartz, I got myself the Prismarine, because we also got ourselves Magmatation, or Catalyst thingy underneath that, which I forgot we had in that one.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Yeah.
We needed it.
We kind of do need it, but I absolutely forgot about it, so. Even though my tooltip says so.
Yeah, you should see it before you drop it in.
I blame you. Blame.
I did put it there, but still. You helped make it.
I have myself a Wand of the Forest with 2 petals that I didn't use, and I believe this could be your wand, I surprise.
I have a pure red one.
Oh.
I still have Dawn Meat.
I have a grey one for some reason, and it isn't mine. And I still have another one in my bag, so I'm not sure who is. This
well, is. Mine, I used 2 red petals because I'm doing blood magic.
I used blue and orange because, well, I just like the way they look. Don't judge me. Let's see.
Guys, I'm actually gonna have the game for now. I have some studying to do, cooking, and a whole bunch of other stuff, so...
Alright, have fun with that then, I guess.
Yeah, right. I will. Take care, guys. Have fun with Minecraft.
Thank you.
Alright, I'll see you guys around. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Take care.
User disconnected from your channel.
Okay, all 5 runes. 1, 2, 3, 4 blood runes. And an attuned stone, which is a lava bucket, whiff of magic, and a mana diamond. I think...
Don't forget that's also in the runic altar, I think.
What in the runic altar?
The attuned stone.
I don't know what you mean.
Does it show a regular crafting recipe?
Yes.
Let me fix that again. Desync again.
Right, yeah. Okay, we'll be right back, guys, once we actually fixed all this stuff. Alright, guys. So, with some help from an enterprise, I managed to get myself some silverwood logs, as he found a mystical biome thingy. So we got one sapling that's still being planted somewhere, so that's pretty awesome. Which means now we're able to actually get into Essentia Desolation. Which requires a couple of things. I probably want to make 4 arcane alembixes. Alembi, I'm not really sure how you pronounce that. But I need 2 V-filters, which is just 2 silverwood planks and 4 pieces of gold, which is surprisingly cheap for looking at how the rest of the recipes are very not that simple. So we got that, we got ourselves some iron, thankfully, also thanks to Enterprise due to his mining ritual. If you're watching this, Enterprise, and he currently isn't on TeamSpeak, by the way, but if you're watching this, thank you very much for everything you're doing to help me progress a little bit further. I'm thinking of making one to get back at home. Hey, Swans is there! Hi, Swans, currently recording. Let's see, I need 2 of these. Wait, no, I only need 1 of these. Wait, surprised that you actually need mana to turn these into logs, but sure. Okay, let's see, I said 2 in the middle, wait, 2, and 2 pieces of gold on the sides, gets me some V filters. I also needed some buckets, I believe. Timecraft, yeah, I need 4 buckets, which is made using the rolling machine thingies, so I need 12 of these. Pretty cool. Then what I need is this goes right there. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. And then I believe that was most of the recipe, right? Oh, and some gold in the corners, of course. Makes sense. And then just have to wait for that. With this, I also want to make myself some warded jars, which require mana glass and a greatwood slab, which is... actually pretty, yeah, it's doable. It's a bit more expensive than the normal recipe, but hey, I guess I can't complain too much as I have seen a lot worse recipes in this thing. So I needed some of that stuff, wooden materials, greatwood slabs, 13, might want to get just a bit more, not really sure how many warded thingamajiggers I want. I guess thingamajiggers is an actual thing now. Let's see, where is my other stuff? Assembly halo, turn this into this stuff. I might want to get a bit more actually, because more mana glass, I mean, because it is rather mana glass intensive, and we still had a bit more. So. And do we even have some more glass somewhere? That's a better question. Oh yeah, we're not really low on glass, so that's awesome. Metal former almost done. Awesome, awesome. There we go, 35, should be enough for to make a couple more of those things that I want. Almost done, hurry up, don't like waiting. Yeah, so I'm still kind of deciding like what buff I want to go next, because infusion is like the main key thing in Thumbcraft, and from that you're able to do like a lot of different things. So, yeah, that's still something I have to keep in mind, just of what I want to do exactly. So, 4 buckets, awesome, awesome. Combine them with this, gets me the arcane alembixes, alembi, alembu, stuff. Yeah. oh. And of course, I need to make myself the water choice too. Because otherwise, I would be an idiot. There we go. 14. Do I have even have enough mana? I should have. Barely, though. Woohoo! Awesome. Go. So let's see if I can put this thing together. Almost together, as I also need some pedestals. Yes, I get very confused with recipes sometimes. I have enough to make 10. Oh, awesome. Do I need these for anything else? I do think so, so I'm not going to use all of them up. But I do believe I also need some of these. Yeah. Throw that stuff on the ground. Let me quickly sort. Put some stuff in my bag for now. Cool stuff. And the infusion matrix, or runic matrix, sorry, that goes with this thing. Awesome. So let's see if I can put this structure together. So if I look into the oh-so-awesome Tom-a-nama-nama-nama-nama-con, the recipe follows. 1 arcane pedestal, 4 arcane stone bricks, and 4 normal arcane stone blocks, and then the runic matrix on top of it. So let's see, what's the center of this room? I think it's right there, so let's put a arcane pedestal right there. This can go around right there. 1, 2, 3. Derp, I need one more, but that's not a big deal because I needed to get some more mana anyway. Or I saw more V, as we were almost or completely out. And this thing requires like 25 V of each, I believe. So that's cool. And I need a place to actually put the... what are they called? The arcane lambixes and stuff. So what I might do, and it is a might with a capital M, is make this like a glass wall. And then put the arcane alembic setup, or alchemical furnace and everything, on the other side of the wall, as this essentially can flow through walls. Just have it a little bit more separated and looking nicely. So that's what I will quickly do. Get one more arcane stone block, get this arcane pedestal, make a little room right here, and I will be right back. Alrighty. So, there we go, guys. I managed myself to get myself the materials that I needed, thanks to Swans, as he's also a Tomer Church on the server, so he managed to get me the Arcane Pedestal and the Arcane Block. And I made this room right here, where I put the 14, 13, I don't know exactly how many water jars I made, right here, together with the Arcane Alembic. Because this structure is like pretty much 5 high because of the arcane alembics that I'm using, I had to dig into the floor. But hey, it looks pretty cool anyway, so that's pretty nice. So yeah, let's... oh, and I also recharged my wand completely, so let's do this. 3, 2, 1. Ooh. Okay, first of all, this thing is glitching through the roof. But it's working apparently. And I always love when I see this structure in-game, because it means that I'm able to do a lot of awesome stuff. Woohoo! So, yeah, let's see if we can already break some stuff down. Or at least see some cool recipes. Like, maybe the Boots of the Traveler, which require Volatus and Iter. Iter is, I believe, able to be obtained from trapdoors. And Volatus from from feathers. That's the one. So let's actually see how true I am making those statements. So trapdoors. I have not scanned it yet. So let's do that right now. Oh wait, no, that's Modus. Then I'm not quite sure. Let's see how many feathers we have though. This is not a lot of feathers. Anything else maybe that has it? Let me quickly do some research into what... or a bit more searching around. Oh wait, I discovered a new clue. Oh awesome, a thermostatic girdle. Which is an upgrade to the thermostatic harness, which has a very annoying recipe, as you can already see. As it requires void chest plates, so that's already something we're not able to get anytime soon. And the thermostatic girdle... It is able to prevent fall damage, and when worn with the harness, it greatly increases the speed at which you're able to fly. Huh, that's pretty awesome. So yeah, like I said, let's do a little bit of quick research, and then I don't mean TomCraft research, but actual online research, and I'll be right back. Alright guys, so I got myself all the aspects that I need, and the materials that I need, at least I think so. So we got 24 Arbor, 32 Aether, 32 Aqua, 32 Valetus, and 16 Air. But we only need the Aether and the Valetus, so we should be good to go. And then let's quickly double check the materials. For this infusion, I needed 2 Enchanted Fabric, which I have. 2 Air Shards, which I have. Any type of fish. I thought it had to be a puffer fish, so I went through all that trouble to actually doing this. When I'm done recording. Okay. And then, let's see, what else did I need? And a feather. So, yeah, I got that. So, let's see. Let's do this. You can see it go through the wall. At least it should go through the wall, but it just looks like it isn't going through the wall. But that's okay. Maybe I should make like a hole in this thing, just so it looks better, like actually flowing through this thing. Does this work? Woohoo, it does! Awesome. And it's trying to draw the items in. It is going good so far. Hopefully not jinxing it. And boom! Boost of the Traveler. Ah, yeah. Awesome stuff. Woohoo! So, yes, I finally have myself the Boots of the Traveler, which are pretty much a pair of boots that allow you to run faster. And it should automatically make you go up one block, which is also pretty awesome. So yeah, pretty happy with this. But this is not the final thing that I wanted to make with this. Oh no, don't worry about that. I wanted to make the Sojourner Sash. The Sojourner Sash is pretty much a bubble that from Botania that has kind of a similar effect like the Boots of the Traveler. But it's, well, pretty much saves you a spot in your hotbar. And it has some cool upgrades later like the Globetrotter Sash, Planet Strider Sash, and apparently Traveler's Wings for some reason requires one, which I have no idea why, but that's not what I'm going to make. So yes, for this I need some Rune of Earth, a Rune of Air, some Impregnated Leather, and I'm fairly certain we don't have Impregnated Leather though. Let's quickly double check, because if we don't, then I might have to do that a later time. Magic. We do not, but what is required for Impregnated Leather? 4 Whiffs of Magic and Diamond Vapor. We have the Diamond Vapor, but we are out of Whiffs of Magic. Darn. Then I guess I will either do it between the episodes or next episode. But again, I definitely hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Like always, be sure to let me know down in the comment section below if you have any suggestions, feedback, or whatever you would like to share with me. I read all my comments, keep that in mind. So yeah, want something to tell me, just go ahead. I love it when you guys give me feedback. And that, you know, doesn't also include a little thumbs up, thumbs down button, but just in general, love it when you guys give me some feedback that I can actually do something with. So like always, be sure to check out my website in the description below and my forum to stay up to date with all my news and be part of the awesome community. So thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.